Hi, my name is James Cook. I'm with the University of Maine at Augusta, and this is a video, it's our second in a series showing you how to use a really cheap computer called the Raspberry Pi. This is only about $30, and you can use it to connect to the internet to then run some programs that will allow you to engage in original nuts and bolts data mining of social media. You can become a social media researcher on the cheap. How cheap? You could do it at home. This is a home project. Now, in the last video, I talked about how you can connect this computer, which we'll put in a case next, up to a mouse, a keyboard, up to a video unit through HDMI, connect it to a power source, and put in a little tiny micro USB a set of memory so you can run programs. Once you do that, and once you connect the power, you'll get a screen. And that screen is going to guide you into getting started with Raspbian, which is a Linux program that is built for this computer. So all I'm literally going to do is I'm going to select Raspbian, which is recommended, and then I'm going to click install. And it will install the selected operating system, and I'm okay with that. Then it's going to extract that file system, and I'll be ready to go. Okay, so 20 minutes later, I've been informed that the operating system, Raspbian, a Linux installation that's special for the Raspberry Pi, has installed. So now I'm going to click OK. And then a script is going to run, and I'm going to be asked to log in after the script is done. And my temporary username, every user's temporary username when they log in at first, has the username Pi and the password Raspberry. So now that we've installed, all we have to do is click the right arrow, and that will take us to finish on the installation options, the configuration screen. We'll press enter. And that will take us to the login screen. Enter Pi as your username, Raspberry as your password, and you'll be all set. In the next video, we're going to take a look at what the Raspbian desktop environment looks like. That'll be step 3 in the progression toward data mining.